Alright, in case you are new to the PvE tier list, because this is a newer format that I recently did, I think this is the second video with this format, I want to explain it really quickly. So, for this tier list, we are talking about general PvE investment. This includes VE Tower, Climax Battle, and Club Festival, all three of those things, okay? So if a character is good in all three of those things, they are S tier. If they're good in generally like two of those things, they're A tier. If they're good in mainly one thing, might be okay-ish in others, it's B tier or niche. And C tier is like they're rarely used in any of those contents. D is almost never used. F is like, do not touch these characters. Do not build them. Do not invest in them because they're not going to help you with PvE. Okay, so this is kind of a general tier list for PvE. Hopefully it'll help you guys out, help you decide what characters you want to build, what characters you want to work on, and stuff like that. So we are going to start by moving around some older units, or at least really one older unit that I feel like got misplaced terribly. I don't know how he really got placed here, to be honest. I don't know. Maybe I messed up. Maybe I accidentally moved characters to the wrong spot at some point in between making videos. But anyways, Yellow Aizawa down here in D tier, almost never used. I feel like that is definitely not the case. I mean, it might be the case more nowadays that he's not used as much. But if we have Purple Aizawa up here in B tier, I feel like Yellow Aizawa should also be up in B tier. And that's how a lot of other players felt as well. They were like, why is he down in D tier? He's been goated since day one. You know, and while he's not as good, he used to be like S tier at day one, you know, but now he's not as good in some of the other forms of content. Like, he's not as good in Club Festival because you need like AoE attacks a lot of the time for that. So he's good in like one thing mainly, and I would say that's VE Tower, right? And he's not going to be as good in Climax Battle. A lot of Climax Battles he's not super great in. He might be okay in like one of the Climax Battles, but when we talk about being good in Climax Battle, we're talking about like they can be used in a good amount of them, at least two to three of the Climax Battles, right? So for now, I feel like B tier is a much more generous and understanding place of where he should be, okay? So I feel like that's where the Yellow Aizawa should be. With that said, we will just move right into the newer units. So we're going to be starting with Yellow Hawks, all right? So Mind Hawks and Endeavor, I guess if you want to call them, they're like a dual unit. They are typically only really good for supporting pro heroes, and even then they're giving speed and evasion, which is not super super great for PvE content. They may be okay for like Club Festival with the skill cooldown thing. They might be really good for that. We'll have to see. So there's an argument for them to potentially move up or down from where I place them right now, but we just haven't had a Club Festival to test them out, right? So for right now though, I think we're going to put this Yellow Hawks with all of his other brothers here in C tier, rarely used. I don't think we're going to see him used. He might have an argument to move up to B when Club Festival comes out because he might be potentially really good in Club Festival. We don't know yet. We will have to see whenever the new Club Festival comes out where that Hawks places. But just keep in mind, there is a possibility, a potential future where he does move up in the tier list. Next, we have Star and Stripe. So Star and Stripe is really better against INT units, and I said this in the other video, I said this in the PvP video, whichever one you're watching first doesn't matter, but Star and Stripe is more of like a budget Fest Ida. Okay, so Fest Ida, Fantasy Ida, is really good because he can draw aggro whenever he gains evasion, right? And that's super helpful to keep your team alive, whether that is Club Festival, whether that's VE Tower, or specifically, I feel like Club Festida does well in Climax Battle. That's where he really tends to shine more than the other events. And so Festida is up here in A tier because he's good at least two things. Like generally, he's okay at two things. Whereas Star and Stripe, I don't know. I feel like she's okay. She could be good in Climax Battle. Like, she's definitely good. She could be very good in Climax Battle. I'll give her that. And a couple of them, she could be good. And then when it comes to Club Festival, she might be good because of her AoE. And if we're taking on like an int type day, maybe she'll be good for that. Okay. And then when it comes to VE Tower, though, I don't know how great she'll be. So for right now, I think she's going to be decent at two things. Once again, there's an argument to move her down or up. We just don't know for sure because we don't have Club Festival yet. So just keep that in mind whenever I'm saying these things. We haven't tested these characters in Club Festival yet, so we don't know. But we're going to go ahead and put her into, sorry, not A tier. I apologize. That was the completely wrong place. We're going to put her into B tier right now, because while I feel like she could be good at two things, I don't know yet, because she's not in Club Festival. We haven't tried her in Club Festival. So right now, as of right now, we know she'll be good in Climax Battle, right? That's kind of, I think, the opinion of people for where she sits. Next, I'm actually going to do Climax Battle All Might next. Before I do the Steampunk characters, I'll do the Steampunk characters last. So Climax Battle All Might is tentatively, okay, meaning it could be changed, just like Star and Stripe, going to be placed into A tier. So he is the one going to A tier, okay? So we're putting him in A tier because he is one of the best tanks in the game, and his tranquility, and he has technical hits, and he has good cooldowns. Okay, so he has a lot of things that could potentially be good. So he could be decent in VE Tower, especially with keeping tanky and stuff like that. He could be good in Climax Battle. The one place I don't think you'll find a ton of use for him is Club Festival, if I'm being honest, okay? And honestly, there might be an argument to move him down to B tier. We might argue that he's only really gonna be good in Climax Battle because he is a tank. Like, while he does have a technical and decent cooldowns, that might not be enough for him to be good in VE Tower compared to some other characters. So he could definitely be B tier, but for now, we're going to put him in A tier. We'll have to see whenever we have a VE tower come back as well. So yeah, just keep that in mind. Next, Steampunk Bakugo. Steampunk Bakugo is an interesting character, to say the least. He is a character I thought was going to be very good when I first looked at his kit, and when I tested him out in PvP, I was a little bit disappointed, but I still think he can be a decent character when it comes to PvE. So he can buff his allies, and he also has good DPS. It is kind of weird to get 10 stacks of Nitro though, and that kind of throws him off when it comes to being really good in PvE, but I could see him being potentially good in a Club Festival, once again, whenever we're able to test that. I could see him being good in VE Tower. I could also see him being good in not the current Climax Battle, but in a couple of the Climax Battles. So for now, I would put him in A tier, because I don't know how good he's actually going to be in Climax Battles overall, but I do think there's potential for Club Fest, and there's potential for VE Tower, okay? So two things I think he'll be generally okay in. Once again, could end up moving him down. I doubt we move him up, though. I think like A tier is the epitome or the max that this Steampunk Bakugo goes to. I don't think he'll ever quite make it to the tier of the characters above him, unfortunately. And then last but not least, we have Steampunk Deku. So Steampunk Deku has really good, like, god tier plus ultras with very little investment. Like, that is insanely good for VE Tower. Like, that is freaking amazing. It's so good, okay? Now, he may go up or down depending on, you know, when we test him in VE Tower, Club Festival, all that stuff, just like the other characters. I've been saying this for every character, I just can't stress it enough, right? These are tentative for most of these, but he can be one, like, a very, very good tank slash HP character as well, because that will stack every time he doesn't hit a crit. Now, the problem with him is that he has consistent Pierce, and Pierce is punished a lot in a lot of different forms of content, whether it's Climax Battle, VE Tower, sometimes Club Festival, okay? Additionally, that Pierce can do too much damage in VE Tower, and you kill enemies too quickly. So I feel like literally because he can end up killing people too quickly in PvE content, we're gonna put him into A tier. There is an option though, potentially, a foreseeable future maybe, where he does end up in S tier, but the single target attack is what's probably gonna hold him back in Club Festival from being good, but you never know, he might be good. We might have some characters we have to pierce or something like that. So Steampunk Deku could potentially, eventually, maybe, go to S tier in the future, but for right now we're gonna put him in A. He could also go down to B, but I think he will pretty much always be an option when it comes to VE Tower. Like, I think he's actually a very decent option when it comes to VE Tower because of what he can do. However, he can do too much damage, which is a little bit scary. I think he will always be an option for Climax Battle because he is good in the All Might Climax Battle, and he'll probably be good in other Climax Battles too. Pretty easy to say when a character has constant Pierce, right? So two things for sure that he's good in. Maybe might end up being good in Club Festival. We'll have to see in the future. But that is the new PvE tier list for May of 2024. These characters up here are the ones you should invest in. I would probably go all the way down to like I don't know, B tier. Some of the characters in C tier are worth investing in, like Hawks is worth investing in, Red All For One is worth investing in. He's actually really good in the current All Might Climax battle. He is rarely used. I think this is like one of the only places we've ever used the Red All For One, but we're using him right now. So like, it's fair to say that he's in C tier because he is getting used. He's not almost never used. He gets used sometimes, but just not all that much. But like right now, he is actually really, really goated and really good in the All Might Climax battle. So some of these characters down here in C tier are worth building, but I'd say from B tier up, like all of those characters for the most part have some uses at some point in the game where you're going to be able to use them potentially. So that is it for this tier list. If you guys did enjoy the video, please consider going down there, hitting that like button, hitting that subscribe button, and let me know your guys' thoughts down in the comments. Do you think any character should be moved up or down? We'll take that into account and we'll try to adjust next time. Peace.